Okay, now let's summon what we learned from the different kicking defense technique. Okay, so we have the low kick, we have the middle kick, and high kick. That's basically all round kicks, and then you have the straight up kicks like front kick and side kick. Okay, so first he's gonna attack me with various attacks, random attacks, and I walk with him a little bit, and then show you the defense technique to summarize why we do the kick defense like we do it. Okay, so. Ja, so das low anfangen, bam, 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 ja, genau, gut, ja, genau, und dann round, genau, ja, bam, bam, ja, und dann hier, bam, genau, genau, ja, gut, gut, ja, und dann hier, bam, ja, gut, ja, und bam, genau, ja, gut, ja, und bam, bam. So, now you see how it's like when a kickboxer or whatever kicks me, okay, attacks me with the legs and defends with the hands, or distract me with the hands, and attack me with the legs. So we talk about three things now. Distance, eh? Close the distance, and then what about the hands? Okay, hand and leg, okay, as contrast. And then the last one is balance. Okay, so distance, what I talk about is when he, especially long kicks, like a middle kick, bam, eh? He expects the kick to land somewhere here. If it does it, okay? And then if I wait, I go away from this area, but I give him more distance for the next kick, okay? Here, and then next kick. Or kick me the other leg when he switch, okay? Here, one and two, and I get kicked, okay? But if I close the distance, it's gonna be difficult, but you have to watch the hand, okay? Watch the boxing. And then he kicks me, and then close, and then I close him, and then I stick on him, so can he, if I, like, in a clinch situation, it's very difficult for him to kick now, right? He can knees me or elbow me, but not kick. That's the point, okay? Even the low kicks, he attacks me, and then I go in, yeah? And but when I go out, he can kick me again, yeah? But then again, I go in, and then I stay here, and then stay here, stay here, and then like this, and I take him, yeah, and he can kick me. Simple. Also, front kick is very dangerous because front kick is the kick with less shadows. In Chinese, we call the shadow when the upper body is moving. Yeah. If he gives round kick, upper body moves first. Now he kicks me. I see this 2 seconds before the kick landing. So that's why I always can react first. He wants to kick, bam! I already react. All right. But front kick, he can actually stay like that and then kick me with the rear leg. Yeah? Kick the rear leg, back leg. Yeah, like this. And it's very difficult because I see it too late. So that's why you have to use your hand like here, not here. Okay? And you can front kick him again. My hand is already in the space with the kick will travel. Okay? But my hand like this, and he kick me, it's very dangerous, very risky to close the gap. So I also have to build a bridge and stuff like that. So second is the similarity, but also the difference between hand and kicking. In Chinese, we say if he kicks, he becomes shorter, and if he punch, he becomes longer. So what does that mean? If he kicks me, and I wait, okay? This is second option, okay? I wait, and then again, okay? Again, and then, again, and then bam, huh? There's a small time window where he can move because he's rebalancing himself, okay? Very small, some people very quick, and they do the tornado, whatever, kicks, and combines it, but it's still always a small window because if he kicks me, he is changing his distance, but the standing leg cannot move. That's the point, okay? And that's why I can close also. He kicks, and then close, yeah? Because he can't go back at that moment. He kicks, and then close, he can walk at the moment of the kick with the other leg. That's why he's actually becoming not mobile anymore. But if he punches me, and I go back, and he can follow me because he can use both legs if he punch. So boxing is actually very, very, very good for self-defense. And kicking, not so much, okay? So if I have to choose between all the combat sports, I would choose boxing, always. Not kicking, not one bit, okay? So And if he box me and I walk towards him to close, he can walk away and still box me. He's always mobile because his structure, like in Yun Chun and Tai Chi and Kung Fu, his structure, the door is always in balance because he's using his legs to balance himself. And then he can use both hands to attack me or to defend, whatever. Okay, so this is the second aspect. The last aspect is balance. Most likely, the bigger kicks, like a side kick me, bam. And then if I catch it, like now he is losing balance. And then can I throw him and stuff like that. Or the middle kick, the round middle kick, and then here, and then I can throw him. Yeah, and then I go in, whatever. Okay? That's pretty obvious because he's standing on one leg, all right? Even if he's doing a low kick, okay? He gives me low kick, and then go in, and he has to step back a lot more if I standing on bow leg, and then just punch me, and then I go in. Look, it's very stable structure, very good structure. But if he does low kick, and then do the same, and then lose his balance. And then I can follow up with attacks, with a throw, whatever. And then he can hit the low kick again, I can pull him better. Yeah? But if he just punched me, and again, I cannot pull him that much because he can recorrect his position with both legs. But in the moment when you lift the leg, that's the moment when I attack. And I don't lift my leg so much. Even if I do the knee defense, he do a low kick, and then, but my leg is on the ground. You see, I did not do this. Huh? He got low kick, it's still on the ground. And then you follow up with attacks because you can walk while he cannot walk. So it sounds easy, every single aspect, but you see, you have to train every single technique. We showed you with the cloud hand, catching, knee defense, whatever throws, to combine it. It has to be molded together, okay? What will help you is not the single exercise, but do pushing hand and shizao. It will change your movement, it change your timing, your perception of timing, of distance. And that's why we do it. Not because we fight like this. You know, nobody gonna fight like this. But it changed my sensibility about the area, what happens before me. Okay? So, and see you next time.